Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum, my dear students. The current session focuses on sociolinguistics and the sociology of language. I hope and expect by the end of the session, you would not only be able to differentiate between the two terms, but also you would be able to understand how they are related to each other. To start with, I would talk about what is sociolinguistics, and I hope you have some idea of what sociolinguistics is. Sociolinguistics, in fact, is the study of language in relation to society, implying intentionally that sociolinguistics is part of the study of language. Because language cannot be studied without considering the social and the cultural context. So, my dear students, the value of sociolinguistics is the light which it throws on the nature of language in general, or the characteristics of some particular language. So, you know, generally how people use language, what are important social aspects of language use or choices, and not only this general aspect, but also any particular language or any particular dialect, how it is particularly used for performing particular functions or for, various purposes in a particular society. This all comes under the studies that are done in sociolinguistics. On the other hand, when we compare it with sociology of language, we need to understand what does the term sociology of language mean. We also need to understand how does it differ from sociolinguistics. Well, my dear students, defining the sociology of language, I would say it is the study of the relations between language and society. Now, it is very interesting. When I defined at the outset of this session sociolinguistics, I said it is the relationship between language and society. And here again, sociology of language, I'm defining it as the relationship, study of the relationship between language and society. The question arises, then what is it that makes them different from each other? Well, my dear students, the difference is that sociolinguistics focuses on the effect of society on language. You know, how does society impact language? Whereas sociology of language is completely opposite to that. It looks at how language as a tool operates, or how does it work, and how does it influence society. So, you know, if we combine these two, we can say this is a two-way process, but actually each of them operates completely opposite to each other. The sociology of language totally focuses on how language has an impact on shaping or defining or reforming a particular society. Also, I would say that the sociology of language seeks to understand the way that social dynamics are affected by individual and group language choices. What does it mean? It means how a particular individual or how a particular group uses language would have an influence on shaping or making or, you know, remodifying the social structures, and sociology of language studies all that. Commenting on the sociology of language, Su Xiaoshen asserts language is considered to be a social value within this field, which researches social groups for phenomena like multilingualism and linguistic conflict. So, you know, how people use more than one languages within a society and what is the influence of all that on the society is a part of the studies in sociology of language. I would give the example of Pakistan, where, for example, people use English, Urdu, and then their regional languages according to the situation, and they mix them up. They switch the codes as well. So what is the impact of all that we can notice in the society? This falls under the studies in sociology of language. So it would have to do with who is authorized to use what language, with whom, and under what conditions. The direction or the dimension from where the studies in sociology of language come are from moving from language to society. Whereas in sociolinguistics, it is the other way around. The movement or direction of examining the whole phenomena is from society to language. And in fact, it not only deals with the groups, how do they use language, but also how individuals in different capacities create their identities by making different linguistic choices in different social contexts.